Hello everyone, hope you're all doing well. Welcome back to more Esports Talk on a very important issue that's happened over the past week or so, that being Twitch's ban issues, because they are so severe and actually getting way worse as we do speak. Of course, if you guys do not know what I'm talking about, the latest clip out there, thanks to a streamer known as Amouranth, I'm probably going to mispronounce her name several times throughout this. I want to show you guys, though, context and comparison between several streamers out there and why Twitch's ban issue is very severe, and what exactly the issue is, I'm not really sure. So going forward, I hope this video does help them decide how exactly they're going to enforce their rules. But let's look back to March of this year, guys. It was actually involving Pokimane, who very clearly did not say the N-word, although accusations do arise out of these stumble of words, or these very close words to what pertains to be most of the time the N-word. So people thought she said the N-word. She very obvious to most people out there said Anivia, a direct reference to a League of Legends character in the actual clip I'll play for you guys right now.
Damn. This nigga's getting fucked.
So for that, she received no ban, and I am fine with that. I'm not trying to call Pokimane out here. I know people can take things a bit out of context here and there. It's not her fault, right? She didn't say the word. She wasn't punished. The situation is over. What becomes the issue, though, is the subjective actual issues in terms of ban policies that Twitch uses against similar circumstances, that being with a month later in April, a streamer, also a Liquid Pro sub himself, that being TFBlade, the same exact issue. He also, if you guys do watch him, has a bit of an accent, so it adds to the controversy where people thought he actually said, again, the N-word, although it's very clear to people like me and a majority of the community out there heard the word idiots. I'll play you guys the clip right now.
Oh, that was just nice, isn't it? FTP at least. Okay, we get Infernal, maybe. Go, 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 just go. Holy shit, kill these idiots. Nice.
And for this circumstance, it was actually initially a 30-day ban given to TFBlade. It was not until a large portion of the community actually said no. He said the word idiots. Even YouTube captions, which are not always right, caught the word idiots. Even Liquid's owner himself, Steve, had to come forward and say, hey, I'm clearing my player's name. He did not say the N-word. I know this guy. And he clearly did say the word idiots. The majority of the community did back him up. And you know what happened, guys? Twitch then reduced his ban from 30 days to 7 days, citing as to why, because apparently the subjective team over there, the entire team heard the N-word, and so they reduced his punishment. Almost as if you would take this out of context, you could interpret this as this. They found out, oh my gosh, he didn't say the N-word. Let's not give him the reduced ban entirely. Let's have our pride intact here. So prideful Twitch staff, they said, you know what? We'll give you a 7-day ban instead. If he had said the word, you leave the ban. If he didn't say the word, then you give the ban up. But instead, they reduced his ban. So right there directly, we have an issue in terms of how Pokimane's case was handled and how TFBlade's case was handled. Now, also, of course, most recently, we have Amouranth, and I don't care if I mispronounce her name, guys. The most controversial of the three people I've showed you so far, by far and away, it's the least distinguishable as to exactly what she did say. Apparently, right now, the controversy again lies in whether or not she said the N-word. I think it was actually N-store was the term, or did she say in the grocery store? Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys. You guys can leave your comments down below. When I first heard this clip, I clearly heard the N-word. Although with context, when someone told me in the grocery store, I did hear in the grocery store. Although as of right now, I think it's fair to say a far majority of the community do believe she actually said the N-word. I'll leave it up to you guys, though. I'm not going to play the clip because it's still not determined whether or not she did say it. I will link it down below for all of you guys because I just don't want to get any bans for this. So if you want to hear it, please click on the link down below and then resume this video. And for that, she has still not yet been banned. So what is the issue? What it seems to be as of right now, I'm not trying to call out Twitch for giving females more power or I guess more preferential treatment than males. I'm not trying to call them sexist, although based off the examples we have seen over the past month or so over 2019, it does seem a bit of that direction, or the subjective team over there just has a real big issue determining what is said and what has not been said. Now, that's not the only issue. Of course, we bring up the Alinity cat abuse case, where Alinity was obviously clearly abusing her cat in multiple ways. I've already had a video on this. I'll link down below for all of you guys. Several ways abusing her cat and has somehow not received a ban. That's the most astonishing of all of these cases. And then, of course, thanks to Keemstar, he pointed this out. Another streamer, a lesser streamer, of course, he actually dropped his catfish on stream once and he received a ban for that. So I don't think it's only a preferential treatment issue between female streamers and male streamers. I think it's a big thing as well, because all of these streamers that are females I did mention are fairly large female streamers. Of course, TFBlade's a pretty sizable one as well, but these are some of your top female streamers out there. So it does beg the question of why Twitch is not banning them and giving out bans to people like TFBlade. And I hope you guys can understand the controversy. I'm not trying to say anything is going on, but with all the evidence out there, it does seem a bit odd how the Twitch staff has been acting on their bans towards some streamers over others. And if we want to dilute this away from the whole, you know, is Twitch sexist thing, we could also bring up Dr. Disrespect. And again, I'm not blaming these streamers, guys, okay? It's not their fault that Twitch did not ban them or gave them a minimal ban. Dr. Disrespect, of course, walking into an E3 bathroom. It was his first offense, by the way, and they gave him a minimal 2-week ban, although historically speaking, we can assume, and based off examples I did share in that video as well, we've had other streamers break those same privacy laws and receive permanent bans or much longer than 2-week bans. So now you draw in the question, are larger streamers given favoritism on the platform compared to lesser or smaller streamers? And from a business standpoint, it seems obvious that would make sense for Twitch to do. And so that's why when we actually talk about these cases, you think that something must be going on. So that's it for right now, guys. I think Twitch has severe ban issues. Again, I'm not trying to blame these streamers, although Amouranth, I'm not really sure if she did say it or not. Obviously, if she did say it, I would blame her. But when it comes down to those cases, you know, Pokimane and TFBlade, arguably controversial clips, one gets a ban, one does not. Amouranth is still not banned for a very controversial clip as well. And again, TFBlade was given his ban almost right away after that very, very controversial statement. Alinity is one of the most the stupidest cases I've seen in quite some time on Twitch. There are multiple clips of her abusing her animals or her animal Milo, her cat, and still nothing has happened to that. And then even bringing the Dr. Disrespect case, and there are just so many controversies and so many debatable points out there as to what Twitch staff is doing, and it's obviously not a good job throughout 2019 so far. You guys can leave your thoughts down below as well as your comments. I would gladly read through them, guys. As always, my name is Jake, breaking down esports and gaming news here every single day. And until next time, guys, stay tuned. I'll see you soon.